Good evening, sir. Today is 17th October, Saturday, and today we are going to present on the topic Mealy and Moon Machine. This topic will be presented by Reema De, Srijita Roy, and Rudranil Mandal. The contents of this topic are Mealy Machine with an example, Moon Machine with an example. It's important for us to know the basic difference between these two machines, that is Mealy machine and Moore machine. Also, we'll discuss about the conversion of Mealy to Moore machine and Moore to Mealy machine. And at last, we'll discuss some gate level questions. So, the first topic, that is Mealy machine. Mealy machine are finite state machines with output value, and the output value depends on the present state and current input symbol. It can be represented as a six-tuple form Q, Q0, epsilon, O, delta, and lambda dash, where Q stands for finite set of states, Q0 is the initial state, epsilon is the input alphabet, O is the output alphabet, delta is the transition function which maps Q cross epsilon to Q, and lambda dash is the output function which maps Q cross epsilon to O. So, to get a deep knowledge about Mealy machine, let us discuss an example for the same. In the Mealy machine shown here, the output represented with each input symbol for each state is separated by a slash. The length of output for a Mealy machine is equal to the length of input in case of a Mealy machine. So, let us first, for an example, take 1-1 to be the input which we will give in the machine. So, here the transition function will be equal to delta Q0 1-1 means when we are giving 1 as input, then we'll see that from Q0 to Q2, when we are going, the output will be 0 when we give input as 1. Then again, when we are giving 1 as input, it will come back to Q2, and so the output will be 0. So the final output will be 0-0, as I have explained right now. Now I will tell Srijita to explain this.
So our next topic is Moore machine. Moore machine is a finite state machines with output value, and the output value depends only on the present state. It can be represented in a six tuple form, that is capital Q, Q0, epsilon, O, delta, and lambda dash, where Q stands for set of states. Is a finite set of states. Q0 is the initial state. Epsilon is the input alphabet. O is the output alphabet, and lambda is the transition output function which maps from Q to O, and delta is the transition function which maps from Q cross epsilon to Q. Next slide. So here is an example of Moore machine. In the Moore machine shown in the picture, the output is represented with each input state separated by a slash. The length of the output for a Moore machine is greater than input by 1. So here we take an input of 1-1. So in the transition function, we see that delta Q0 1-1, that is when we give Q0 of input of 1, it goes to the state Q2 and gives us the output 0. And again, when we give a 1 input to the Q2 state, it goes to Q2 only. It goes to Q2 only, and the output is again 0. So we get an output of 0 0 0 0 for Q0, 0 for Q2, and again we get 0 for Q2. So we get that Moore machine is associated with the states only. Next, I will tell Rudranil to state the differences between them.
Yes. Now let's look at the difference between Mealy and Moore machine. In case of Mealy machine, the output depends on present state as well as the present input. But as we saw, in case of Moore machine, the output depends only upon present state. In Mealy machine, if input changes, the output also changes. But in case of Moore machine, the output is fixed. That is, if input changes, the output does not change. In Mealy machine, the number of states required is less than that of a Moore machine. Also, there is more hardware requirement for circuit implementation in Mealy machine than Moore machine. Mealy machines react faster to inputs than Moore machines, and they also generate asynchronous output, whereas in Moore machine, synchronous output is generated. In Mealy machine, output is placed on transitions, whereas in Moore machines, output is placed on states. Also, Mealy machine is difficult to design, whereas Moore machine design is comparatively easier.
So now we come to the conversion of Mealy to Moore machine. Here, there is a picture of a Mealy machine given to us. Now we have to convert it to its Moore machine form. So here, for input 0, we can see that from presented for the first time when we do this, the presented state is Q0. So when the input is 0, we'll see that it is going to Q1, and the output is also 0, which is in this way we have inputted here in the table. Similarly, for all the states, we will do the same, and we will get and corresponding Mealy machine transition table. For next case, then for step two, proceeding to the step two, we'll see which states have more than two output values. Here, in case of Q0, we see that it is only has zero as the output, so it doesn't have two outputs. But in case of Q2 and Q1, we see it has 0 and 1 as output for both the cases. So for according to that, we'll form more two states for Q1 and Q2. That is, with output 0, one will be Q1 0 with output 0, and Q1 1 with state output 1. Similar case will happen for Q2, that is Q2 0 and Q2 1. Now we will create an empty Moore machine with the new generated state. So for Moore machine, output will be associated to each state irrespective of inputs. Now to fill the entries, we'll see that here for Q0, when we are giving 1, then we are getting for Q0, when we are giving 0, it is going to Q10. So when we are giving input 1, then it is going to the state Q20. Similarly, for all the other states, in this manner we will fill up the table in this manner, and the corresponding Moore machine will be formed. Now I'll tell Srijita to explain Moore to Mealy machine conversion.
So here we will discuss the conversion from Moore to Mealy machine. Now we'll see a picture of a Moore machine. As we can see that output corresponding to each input in Moore machine transition table. So let us look into the table.
So for input 0, when the present state is Q0, it goes to the next state Q1 and output is 0. So, and for Q10, the next state is Q10 and output is 0. And similarly, for input 1,
we make the table for the Moore machine. Next state. So here is the modified picture. As we can see in the previous table that Q10 and Q11 are similar to each other. that is the same value of next state and output for different inputs only. Similarly, Q20 and Q21 are also similar, so Q11 and Q21 and 0, 1, 0 and 1 respectively. So let us look into the Mealy machine table. For input, and as there were Q0, Q1 and Q2 inputs in the Moore machine, here we are seeing the same states Q0, Q1 and Q2. And for Q0, the next state is Q1 for input 0, and for input 1, the next state it is Q2. For Q1, for input 0, the next state is Q1, and for input 1, the next state is Q2. So similarly we do for Q2. So from here it is clear that Mealy machine output is only associated with the transitions, and for Moore machine the output is associated with the states. That is the main difference between Moore and Mealy machine. Next I will ask Rudranil to discuss about some gate level questions.
Let's look into some gate level questions for Mealy and Moore machine. Now, question number one. The question says, the finite state machine described by the following state diagram given here, with A as starting state, where an arc level is X or Y, and X stands for 1-bit input and Y stands for 2-bit input. Option A, outputs the sum of the present and the previous bits of the input. Option B, outputs 0-1 whenever the input sequence contains 1-1. Option C, outputs 0-0. Whenever the input sequence contains 1-0, and option D, none of this. Now let's look at the answer. The answer for this question will be option A. As we can see, suppose we can prove this by taking any binary input. So let's assume an input string will be 1101. So the first input 1, when given to the state A, goes into state B with the output 0-1. So here we can see that the output is equal to the previous input bit plus the present input bit. Now, when the next input 1 is given to the current state B, then it goes to the state C and the output generated is 1-0. So we can confirm that the output is equal to the previous input bit plus the present input bit. So we can see the answer will be option A. It can be further verified by looking at the next inputs. Now let's move to the next question. Yes, question number 2 says, the following Mealy machine outputs which of the following? This is the diagram of the Mealy machine. Option A, 9's complement, B2's complement, C1's complement and D is 10's complement. So from the diagram we can see that the output generated will be 2's complement. And for the explanation, let's assume a binary string which is 1101, or sorry, it will be 1011, and let's check at the output. First, 1 will be the input and there will be a transition from Q0 to Q1 with an output of 1. The next input will be 1 and the transition will be from QF to QL and produce an output of 0. Then the next input will be 0 and the transition will be from QF to QL with an output of 1. And for the last input 1, the transition will be from QF to QL and it will generate an output of 1. So then the output will be 0101, which is equal to the 2's complement of the input. So the output is equal to 2's complement. Now moving to the next question. The ratio of number of input to the number of output in a Mealy machine can be given as option A 1, option B n is to n plus 1, option C n plus 1 is to n, option D none of the mentioned. Now the answer for this question will be option A, that is 1, because in Mealy machine the output depends only on follows the transition in place of states as in the Moore machine. So now let's move to the next question. The next question has two statements. Statement 1, null string is accepted in Moore machine. Statement 2, there are more than 5 tuples in the definition of Moore machine. So we have to determine which of the statement is true or false. Now in this question, both the statements will be true, because even if epsilon is passed into a Moore machine, it produces an output. And as we know from definition, the Moore machine contains 6 tuples, which is more than 5 obviously. So the answer will be option A. Now let's move to the last question. Yes, the last question shows the total number of states and transitions required to form a Moore machine that will produce residue mod 3 will be 3 and 6, or 3 and 5, or 2 and 4, or 2 and 5. Now, as it is residue mod 3, the answer will comprise of 3 and 6, which is option A. And the corresponding Moore machine diagram is provided in the answer.
Thank you. Very good presentation. Very neat presentation.